In this class, let us study Para 4. Para 4 talks about transfer of business assets. So whenever I am transferring business assets, I need to know, am I supplying goods or am I supplying services? So Para 4 helps me to determine whether I am supplying goods or supplying services. There can be total 3 situations. Let us study these situations one by one. First situation says, transfer or disposal of business assets. Transfer or disposal of business assets. So as to it won't form part of the assets anymore. What am I trying to say? Let us take an example to understand this. Say I am jewelry shop owner. And on my anniversary, on my wedding anniversary, I gave a gold necklace to my wife. I gave a gift to my wife, a gold necklace. Now, gold necklace was earlier forming part of my business assets. So it was my business assets earlier, but I gave it as a gift to my wife. Now I transferred it from my business. Now this gold necklace is no more my business assets. In this situation, this transaction will be treated as supply of goods. It is immaterial whether I collect money from my wife or not. Whether I can collect money or I may not collect money. In both the situations, it will be treated as supply of goods. So the first situation says, if I am transferring or disposing any business assets, so that it won't be my business asset anymore, it will be treated as supply of goods. Let us see the second situation. Second situation says, giving the business assets for personal use. Giving the business assets for personal use. Let us take one more example to understand this. I am the same jewelry shop owner and I have so much of gold and jewelry in my shop. Now, my daughter comes one day and she says, she wants one of the necklace. She wants one of the necklace so that she can attend a wedding. Now, I will give this necklace to her and I will tell her, you can use this for one day and at the end of the day, you have to come and give it back. Now, what am I doing? Am I transferring permanently? I am not transferring permanently. Only thing what I am doing is giving the business assets for personal use. Now at the end of the day, the gold will come again. The necklace will come again. In this situation, am I supplying the goods or am I supplying the service? I am supplying the service. In the first case, what happened? I am permanently transferring. In this case, I am only giving it for use. So if I am permanently transferring, it is supply of goods. If I am only giving it for temporary purpose, it is supply of services. Now let us look at the third situation. Third situation says, when a business ceases to exist, what happens? Say I have 2 lakh worth rupee stock in my jewelry shop. I have 2 lakh worth rupee shop, 2 lakh worth rupees stock. Now on one day I decided that my business is running in loss, so I want to close down my business. Now I am closing down my business, all the stock of 2 lakh whatever I have will be treated as supply of goods. Now you may say that I did not sell it to anyone else. The schedule 2 says you need not sell it to anyone else. The moment you close down your business, the moment you cease your business, all your stock will be treated as it is supply of goods. So if I am closing down my business, all the 2 lakh worth rupees of my stock will be treated as I have supplied the goods and I need to pay GST on that. Now this third situation has 2 exceptions. I said whenever I am closing down my business, it will be deemed to be sold or deemed to be supplied. There are 2 exceptions. The exception number 1 is, I am transferring my business. I am not closing down my business, but I am selling my business as a whole. Like I am just selling my entire jewelry shop. So in this situation, it won't be treated as supply of goods. Why? Because the business is not closed. The second exception is, I have appointed someone as representative to run my business. What did I do? Rather than closing my business, I said, my daughter will run my shop. I appointed my daughter as a legal representative to run my shop. In this case also, the business is not closed. So there are only 2 exceptions. The first exception is I am selling my business as whole. So in this situation also, business is not seized. In the second situation, I am not selling my business, but I am appointing a legal representative who will run my business. So in these two situations, it won't be treated as supply of goods. But if I am just closing down my business, this entire 2 lakh worth rupees of stock will be treated as supply of goods. Let us quickly revise whatever we studied in this class. First, I said, if I am transferring the gold necklace to my wife, that is transferring or disposing the business asset, so that it won't be a business asset anymore, it will be treated as supply of goods. The second situation, I said, I am giving the gold necklace to my daughter only for the temporary use, it will be treated as supply of services. Third, I said, if I am closing down my business, if my business ceases to continue, all the stock, all the business assets what I have will be treated as supply of goods. But there are two exceptions. The exception number one is, I am selling the business as a going concern. Second one is, I am appointing a legal representative to run my business. So in these two exceptions, it won't be treated as supply of goods. But in all the other cases where I am closing down my business, it will be treated as supply of goods and I need to pay GST on that.